How surprising would it be if the worker that you scored from another company, polished and honored, leaves your company and turns out to be your biggest rival? Sounds unreal, doesn't it? Well, that is exactly what happened with Steve Jobs and John Sculley. It would appear that after leading through some of its best periods as it ushered the world into the personal computer revolution, Apple's ex-CEO is back with his own company and products to rival the iPhone. Will he be successful? Let's find out. Sculley's smartphone, SF1 and SJ1.5. After his tenure at Apple, John Sculley has started another technological venture known as Obi World Phone. So let's talk about the amazing specs of John Sculley's brand new handsets, SF1 and the SJ1.5. The two smartphone models were announced by the former Apple CEO's company, Obi World Phone, in August 2015. Since it's Obi World Phone's objective to manufacture premium quality phones to the developing markets of countries like Asia, Africa, and the Middle East, these sub-$250 Android devices sound promising when it comes to low-budget smartphones. Sculley described SF1 and SJ1.5 as two high-quality premium-designed smartphones priced at an exceptional value to attracting discerning young people in fast-growth markets in Asia, Africa, and the Middle East. Let's talk about the SF1 first. This model is named after the city of San Francisco. It's an elegant fiberglass Android with a sleek metallic look. Moreover, the SF1 has a 5-inch Gorilla Glass 4 display with a fantastic resolution of 1920x1080. This economical phone also has Dolby Audio with 7.1 channels of high-fidelity speakers. Pretty good so far, right? And not just that, but the 4G LTE smartphone is also outfitted with a Snapdragon 615 processor and has the capacity for 2 SIM cards. Oh, and there's good news for people who love to take pictures, because the SF1 also has a 13-megapixel rear camera powered by Sony's IMX214 XMOR sensor. The camera also has an automatic focus, and it's embellished with geotagging, touch focus, face and smile detection, and 1080p video at 30 frames per second. The front doesn't disappoint as well, with a 5-megapixel camera and LED flash. With a respectable 3000 milliamp battery, the SF1 smartphone is a great device for anyone wishing to buy a budget phone with awesome specs. Now, there are two variations for the SF1. One variant will have 2GB of RAM and 16GB of internal storage, with a price tag of $199, while the other one is equipped with 3GB of RAM and 32GB of storage, but with a price hike, costing $249. What about the other model, the SJ1.5? Named SJ1.5 as an homage to San Jose, this smartphone is comparatively cheaper and it offers more budget specs. With a 5-inch HD Gorilla Glass 3 display, the SJ1.5 is quite good for its price because it's powered by a MediaTek MT6580 quad-core processor and has 16GB of internal storage. The phone also has an expandable memory, so the customers can look forward to that too. Furthermore, there is an option for dual SIM slots. SJ1.5 has a nice pixel display of 720x1280. And to be honest, SJ1.5 is more eye-catching due to its striking look. With a flat top and a round bottom with rubber detailing, it's easier to handle and looks incredibly cool too. Another thing that makes these phones special is that they've been designed by the high-powered San Francisco firm called Ammunition. So both phones have a sleek look to die for, which can be chalked up to Ammunition. And the slightly extruded 5-inch screens not only look very classy, but also offer protection from dropping. According to Sculley, these phones have better components and specs than what their target market is used to. He says, "Our differentiation is no-compromise beautiful design. We said the only way we'll go into this business is if we're convinced we can build products with no compromise. They have to not just look cool, but be perfect in terms of fit and finish." This guy single-handedly boosted the sales of Apple and is considered to be one of the biggest names in the world of business, entrepreneurship, and investment. He also introduced the Obi World Phone in 2014 and made a strong entry into the market. By now, there are 4 models introduced by the Silicon Valley smartphone manufacturer, and one of the models, the SF1, was voted the 5th best smartphone in Vietnam. Sculley's history with Apple. Not many people know that John Sculley was practically the god of marketing in the early 1970s. Due to his ingenuity and proficiency, Sculley made PepsiCo a worldwide success. So when Steve Jobs got wind of it, he offered Sculley a job at Apple. But at the time, Apple wasn't exactly the cash cow it is now. Naturally, Sculley politely refused. But Steve Jobs was determined to take Sculley in because of his soaring success in the marketing industry. Sculley mentions in an interview how Steve Jobs convinced him. He says, "And And Jobs looked me in the eye and said, "Do you want to sell sugary drinks for the rest of your life? Or do you want to join me in changing the world?" Scully further mentions, "I could not say no to him, because if I did that, I would have kept wondering for the rest of my life what would have happened if I had worked with Jobs and helped him in changing the world." He joined Apple in the early 1980s and spent the next 2 decades mass marketing Macintosh personal computers. When he signed at Apple, he got a $1 million signing bonus, $1 million in annual pay, and power over 350,000 shares of Apple. In fact, with his reliable temperament and decent reputation as a marketing guru, he was selected to be the CEO of Apple rather than the great Steve Jobs himself, who severely lacked the discipline and temperament needed to run a company as big as Apple. And so, to this day, Scully is considered one of the most successful entrepreneurs and investors in high-tech startups.
"My job was turn the Apple II around and get it generating as much cash as possible, which we did very successfully."
However, Scully left Apple 4 years after joining because of his fallout with Steve Jobs, as well as the tremendous pressure of the job. After increasing the sales of the company from $982 million to $7 billion during his tenure, John Scully finally stepped down and mentioned how there is only so much that a single person can do. But it's the fallout between Scully and Jobs that really soured things to the point of no return. At the time, Jobs was heading the Macintosh team that had its own marketing team, whereas Scully had close to no control over the Macintosh division. Moreover, Jobs was often too spontaneous and unreliable. After multiple power clashes and heated arguments, things came to a head when John Scully called a meeting of the board of directors and presented the entire situation in front of them. This ended up with Steve Jobs losing his position as the general manager of the Macintosh project and him resigning from Apple overall in 1985. But the story doesn't end here. After a long time, John Scully has created his own flagship smartphone, and we couldn't be more eager to check it out. Scully's intentions with his smartphone company. Since Scully had spent a lot of time in India, Africa, the Middle East, and several parts of Asia and had traveled the world a lot, he noticed the emerging market in these countries and how the competition there was not as tough as the Western market. According to John Scully, when he was asked the question of whether they were making their own iPhone with a twist, he replied, "We are really inspired by the tremendous success that Apple has had with the iPhone. But Apple is not really a competitor to us. I brought together the head of Apple's product design, Robert Brunner, who had hired Johnny Ive, and this week, our team worked on preparing smartphones that were a lot cheaper than an iPhone. And to help our marketing team, we presented our product in emerging markets." He mentioned that he will not be taking his business to a market where there is exceptionally high growth and tough competition, and where he has to take business away from a competitor. After all, it's not easy to compete with Chinese companies that are dominating the market for God knows how long. Also, let's remember the fact that John Scully's phone company isn't exactly public. It is a private company, so every move needs to be calculated, because the budget might not allow it. But that's not to say that Scully isn't ambitious and motivated, despite not being young and nimble anymore. He expresses his hopes in these words. "It would be a lot harder if you asked me to fix HTC. I wouldn't have a clue. But if you look at a clean sheet of paper, it's amazing how interesting it can be." If you liked the video, make sure to hit the like and subscribe button. To make sure that you don't miss any future updates, don't forget to turn on the post notifications.